Hi everyone and welcome back. My name is Triston from utahseo.ninja and today I'd like to start something a little bit different for you all. So I've been talking about weebling now for like 2 years and there really isn't a lot more to say. So I've been thinking about how I can find new and interesting content for you guys, things that I can share that I think, you know, would be helpful for your businesses, and I think that I finally found a path to follow. And so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to start talking about some of the new technologies that are coming out that you guys can use to grow your businesses and to reach new customers. To give an example, I want to show you these little guys to you. These are called beacons, and they are low-energy, short-range Bluetooth transmitters that push notifications to mobile devices that either have a designated app for the location or a general-purpose app that is compatible with said device. Whew. Okay, in English, that means that anybody who has a certain app on their phone, whenever they come near one of these devices, they're going to get a notification on their cell phones. And that's really cool. So before I get into the technical stuff, let's talk about how we can use this for business. So I have a couple of companies in mind that I'm working with right now that I think make some really good examples. The first is a plumber. And aside from trying to take over every plumbing-related keyword in the state of California, he had been looking for a way to get more reviews from happy customers for his Yelp listings and Google and things like that. So if he were to program one of these beacons so that it takes people or his clients to his review page after he's finished a job, then that would be really easy for him because it would just be push the button, you're there on the website, and you're able to give him a positive review. And also, since these things are relatively inexpensive, I found them for as little as $10 each, then he could also install one for a larger job that may require future maintenance. That way, if there's ever any sort of problem or it's time for the yearly maintenance, then all you'd have to do is come near the device and it would automatically pull up his information. Another client that I'm working with has a really, really cool chore chart and reward system for kids. Now, for older kids, she could take one of these transmitters and program it to trigger an event whenever they enter a certain room of the house. So, for example, if you have a teenager, whenever they enter the kitchen, they'd automatically receive a notification, you know, once per day, to take out the garbage. And then you'd be able to track when that's done. And if you wanted to go crazy with it, you could even set up a second transmitter. So, for example, you can set it up next to wherever you store your trash cans. And then what would happen is the first device would trigger the notification to go out and take out the trash. And then the second device would record when that action was actually completed, because it would see, okay, you know, notification one went out, 3 minutes later, notification two went out, you know, confirming that the trash had been taken out. So, I mean, that could be a really neat way if you wanted to do a high-tech, you know, chore system for your house. Personally, I want to use these things for tourist attractions. So say you're at a zoo, right? Users would be able to approach a habitat and learn more about the animal. They'd be able to see where it's from, watch videos, share it to Facebook and Twitter, and then buy a panda shirt from the gift shop. You could do the same thing for a concert, selling stuff in the gift shops again. I just came back from the DMV, and they're in a great big office building, and it's pretty easy to get lost in there, and so you could set up a map with one of these beacons. And then not only that, once you actually get to the DMV office, then you can start filling out all the paperwork from your mobile device while you're waiting in line. That would be awesome. If you're at a trade show, then you can give people who visit your booth access to product videos, to white papers, to any other additional information they may need, as well as your contact information. In fact, they could even place their orders online from their mobile devices just because they came in contact with this beacon. You can also program them to trigger whenever somebody leaves an area instead of when they come near an area. So for example, if you have a store, then you can thank people for shopping and offer a coupon on their next purchase. I was reading one story last night about a teacher that was using a beacon to track attendance in his classroom. So all the students in this school have an app on their phone that they can use to get notifications about, you know, closed school days and you know, stuff like that. And they can also use it to ask questions to their teachers whenever they need to. So they were using these beacons so it would trigger whenever a student entered a classroom, then it would automatically record, you know, this student entered this classroom at this time, and that way they can handle all their attendance that way. So as you can see, there are a lot of really, really neat uses for something like this, but there are a couple things that you need to keep in mind before going out and buying 100 of them. I've spoken with a few other business owners about this over the last couple of days, and the first question that always comes to mind is, what kind of tracking and analytics are available for these devices? You know, how can you see how often a device is being activated? How can you see who's using the devices and things like that? And there are a couple of different options. There's actually a platform that you can use, which will show all that information. But also, if you're going to be sending people to a website, which is what I would recommend, then you can also track that information simply using Google Analytics. The next concern is, what would happen if somebody was trying to hack one of these things? And there are actually a few different security systems that are built into this. So you can do password protection, but you can also set it up so that way it'll only activate it if you come near it with your own mobile device. And that would be the only way for it to unlock. So that's another option as well. And then the big question is, how the crap do I program these things? So I don't actually know any programming languages. And, you know, technically HTML isn't actually a programming language. And that's the closest thing that I can do. So I am talking to a few developer buddies right now, and I'm trying to get an idea of how much it would cost to program the device and then also potentially create an app that would interact with them. However, I have seen platforms that will allow you to use their pre-existing apps to interact with the beacons, so all you would need to do is program the hardware, you know, set up the notification. And in fact, I think there's even a way that we can do this as well, but I need to get my hands on a dev kit first and start testing it before I can make any recommendations. But I think that it could be an option that's coming in the near future. But for all my super smart and sexy programming folks out there, if you guys could build us a drag and drop interface for programming these things, and then maybe just a general app that, you know, a user will download and then they can use it across various different locations, you guys would make a fortune from people like me. The next question is, where do we go to actually buy one of these things if we want to? So you can purchase the beacons off of Amazon right now, or you can also order a dev kit from one of the many companies that are developing these things. I've seen individual beacons sold for anywhere between $10 and $15. You can purchase a kit, and depending on the kit, it can cost anywhere between $50 and $100. And that will come with between 3 and 10 individual beacons. And believe it or not, the 10 beacons for $100 is actually the cheapest option. Pricing is based off of lifespan, and then the other thing is the range of the device. And I've seen this go anywhere from 7 meters, which is like 21, 22 feet, up to 50 and 60 meters, which is significantly more. So again, there's a bit of a range as far as price, but there's also a range as far as, like I said, lifespan and range in general. But the expensive part, or at least that is if you don't know how to program something like this, and if that drag and drop platform hasn't been developed yet, is programming these things to do whatever you want to do. Now, there are a lot of different options, but I think that the simplest option would be to push a website URL. And then from there, you can provide all the extra information and functionality that you want from the website. I actually think that Weebly would do a good job for something like this, but I also think that Wix could be an option. And the reason why is because we're talking about something that's going to be used primarily on a mobile device. And Wix has a very, very powerful mobile version editor. And so if you're looking for something that's a lot more user-friendly or design-friendly, then Wix is definitely going to be the more powerful option in that regard. And so that's the beacon, a neat little device that can make a huge difference in the way that we interact with the internet and with businesses in the real world. I plan to order a dev kit sometime next month, and that way I can start playing with these things, see if I can do anything with the programming language. I mean, I like learning that kind of stuff, but we're going to see how it goes. And if not, like I said, I'll see how much it costs to find a developer. But I will definitely be back with another video as soon as I have the kit and as soon as I've played around with it a little bit. So now would be a great time to invite you to subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, so that way you can keep up to date on that. But I'm curious. I want to know how you'd use a beacon in your business. But let me know in the comments. I'm actually really excited to see what you guys can come up with. I think this is a really, really neat technology, and I'm excited to see how you guys plan to use it. And also let me know if you like this kind of content. Like I said, we're doing something a little bit different today. And you can do so by giving the video a thumbs up. And if not, go ahead and give it a thumbs down. But please let me know why in the comments, so that way I can make any changes and adjustments as needed. And again, my name is Triston from utahseo.ninja, where we help to connect the dots between your business and your customers. Have an excellent day, and I will see you guys next week with a whole new video.